Hello students, I am K.K. Soni, Assistant Professor in Electrical Engineering Department at MIT Kota. Today, I will discuss about sequential logic circuits, which is the fifth unit of Digital Electronics subject of second year, fourth sem in Electrical Engineering Department. In previous lectures, we have learned about combinational logic circuits, in which we have seen various types of combinational logic circuits like adders, subtractors, encoders, decoders, multiplexers and demultiplexers. The combinational circuits are the digital circuits in which the output at any time depends on present inputs only. Now, in sequential logic circuits, the output at any time depends on present inputs and also the past output of the circuit. It means in sequential logic circuits, the output Q is feedback to the input side of the circuit by using a memory element that is called a latch or flip-flop. The basic block diagram of a sequential logic circuit is shown here. Here there is two part. First is combinational circuit and second is memory element. The output is feedback by these memory elements to the input side. Now there are two types of sequential logic circuits: synchronous or clocked logic circuits and asynchronous or unclocked sequential logic circuits. Synchronous or clocked sequential circuits are those circuits in which clock signal is applied to all flip-flops simultaneously or synchronously. Here, synchronization is achieved by using a timing device which is called master clock generator. It generates periodic train of pulses. The setting time of synchronous sequential logic circuits is equal to the highest setting time of a single flip-flop. Due to this, the operation speed is fast in sequential logic circuits in synchronous type. The second is asynchronous or unclocked sequential logic circuits. In this type of logic circuits, all the flip-flops are not clocked simultaneously. It means the output of first flip-flop drives the clock for the second flip-flop, the output of second drives the third, and so on. Therefore, the setting time of asynchronous type sequential circuits is the cumulative sum of individual flip-flop. Due to this, the operation speed is slow. Now, we will discuss about memory element circuit. These are called latches or flip-flops. Now, what is latch? Latch is the simplest kind of sequential logic circuits. It is a 1-bit storage memory that stores 1 bit of digital information in the form of 0 and or 1. It is also called a bistable device. A simple latch circuit consists of two inverters connected like in this figure. This figure is also called cross-coupled inverter latch. There are two inputs X1 and X2 and there are two outputs Q and Q bar. The output Q is called main output or primary output, and the Q bar is called complementary output. Complementary output means that these two outputs are always complement to each other. It means when Q is 1, Q bar is 0, and when Q is 0, the Q bar is 1. The latch circuit may be designed by using NAND or NOR gate also. Now discuss about SAT reset latch. It is also called SR latch. It has two inputs. SAT inputs, it is denoted by S, and other is reset input, that is denoted by R. It has two outputs, Q and Q bar. Block diagram of SR flip-flop is shown in figure here. The circuit diagram by using NOR gate is shown in figure here. The working is defined by the truth table of SR latch. In this truth table, there are three sections: input, output, and action. Now see, there are two inputs. So, the maximum combination of inputs are 4. The value of inputs is 00, 01, 10, and 11. Now, first, we take inputs as 00. S is 0 and R is 0. Then, the output of Q is Qn. Qn means previous output, past output. It means no change. And Q bar is Qn ka bar. It means action is no change. Now, input is taken as 0, 1. S is 0 and R is 1. Now, R is 1. R is the reset input. So, the output of Q is becomes 0. It means it is reset. And Q bar becomes 1. In third case, S is 0 and R is 1. It means, in third case, S is 1 and R is 0. So S is 1, S is the set inputs. So the output of Q is 1 and the Q bar is becomes 0. So this is set in action. And now the last, S is 1 and R is 1. In this condition, the both outputs becomes 1 or 0. That is not considerable in this circuit. So this condition is called forbidden condition, and it is denoted by question mark or small d in the truth table.